गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
गुड आफ्टरनून। सो शैल वी स्टार्ट?
गुड
वी
आफ्टरनून। यस सर।
13 आर देयर। ओके, सो दिस वाज द लास्ट टॉपिक दैट वाज लेफ्ट इन यूनिट नंबर 2, व्हिच इज नथिंग बट द एनालिसिस ऑफ बीजेटी एम्पलीफायर यूजिंग एच पैरामीटर। आई होप एवरीवन नो अबाउट द एच पैरामीटर्स। यस और नो और एनी डाउट्स विद एच पैरामीटर मॉडल? Do you have any doubts in this model H parameter? We have drawn for CE, CB as well as CC. Okay, now in this analysis part, we need to implement the formulas for all, like current gain, voltage gain, so on. So let us see one by one in detail. So what is this network? And what about this one?
Two-port network.
Okay, this is a two-port network. So at the input side, this is nothing but source network. This is nothing but output, which is nothing but load network. Okay, and in a two-port network, generally transistor is used for the sake of an amplification purpose. So it will act as an amplifier. And this is a small signal equivalent model from 1-1 dash to 2-2 dash. This is nothing but a small signal model, which we know generally. Suppose if you want to write this for common emitter, what are the changes in this? Suppose if I want to write it for common emitter, H11 is called as? What is H11?
Input impedance.
Correct, it is input impedance. So it is replaced with HI as it is common emitter. So E. Next, H12 means
reverse voltage gain.
So HRE. F means HFE, HOE. So till now, we have seen till here. Now what I'm doing is I'm trying to connect source network for this. What kind of source network is this? Thevenin's or Norton's?
Thevenin's.
Correct. This is Thevenin's. Second one will be Norton's. And this is nothing but load network. Now first let us derive current gain. So generally what we know, current gain means A stands for gain. Here A subscript I. So it is called as current gain. So it is something which is nothing but the ratio of output by input. So here, what is the output current that you are seeing? Which one is output current here? IL or I2?
Load current.
Here, which one should I take? I1 or else I2 or else IL? Which one is output?
Load current, sir. IL.
IL.
Getting noise. So I need to take IL. But see this direction. Here, I2 is entering, whereas IL is leaving. So always remember one point for a two-port network. Always, if I apply external voltage, there will be a flow of current into the two-port network. So that's why here I1 is entering. At the same time, here I2 is also entering. And to this particular port, I have connected load network. So try to apply KCL at this point. Sum of currents entering is equal to current leaving. So here, currents are not entering. They are leaving. So I2 plus IL is equal to 0. So simply, IL can be written as minus I2. So here output that I need to take is IL. What about input? Input current is?
I1.
So AI is defined as a ratio of change in IL with respect to I1. So I've applied KCL at output node so that I got IL is equal to minus I2. Now instead of IL, you try to substitute this one. So instead of IL, I substituted minus I2. Now, what I know from the H parameter model, V1 is equal to H11 I1 plus H12 V2. At the same time, I2 is equal to H21 I1 plus H22 V2. Suppose if I want output voltage, how to calculate? If I want to calculate V2. V2 means the voltage across this point. How should I write? It is nothing but IL into IL into RL. Or else instead of IL, you can write it like this also, into I2 RL. So I got V2. So here V2 is nothing but minus I2 times RL. See here, I'm making use of this one, which is nothing but second equation. That is, we have V1 as well as I2. Now what I'm doing is I'm substituting V2 as V2 is equal to minus I2 RL. So here I've substituted that value. And by doing normal calculations, I took the common here I2 as common, which is nothing but I2 of 1 plus H2 to RL plus H21 I1. Now my requirement is I want I2 by I1 or else IL by I1. Anything is okay. This can also be written as minus I2 by I1. So here I2 by I1 is nothing but H2 to by 1 plus H2 to RL. Yes or no? But our requirement is AI is minus I2 by I1. So simply add minus here. See, so this is your answer. AI, which is nothing but current gain. Now after doing all this, you can also replace. Here I've not used any suffix like either E or B or C. Why? Here I've written only as HF. Why? Why not HFE? Why not HFB? Or else HFC? What's the change? Here, see. This is nothing but equivalent model for transistor. Suppose if I want to draw this for common emitter, then you need to name it here. This becomes emitter. This one becomes base. This should be collector. Okay. So I've not taken any condition here. Generally, I've drawn. So that's why I'm not mentioning here. Suppose if you want to draw it for particular common emitter, then the answer will be like this. Minus HFE by 1 plus HOERL. Suppose if it is for base, the answer will be HFB by 1 plus HOBRL. Okay, so simply if you know about this derivation, directly you can write the equivalent answers for common emitter, common base, as well as common collector also. This is about AI, which is nothing but current gain. Next, input impedance. How to calculate input impedance? By seeing this diagram, tell me. Input impedance. Here, what's the difference? What is this ZI? What is this ZIS? Both are same or different? Yes, what happened?
Impedance and input impedance.
Okay, tell me about ZI. What is ZI? ZI can be written as V1 by I1. Suppose if I want to write for ZIS, then
I1.
ZIS is VS?
VS by IS.
IS. So here, because of VS, there will be a flow of current called as IS. Now you try to apply KCL at this point. Tell me KCL. Sum of currents entering. Which one is entering? IS is entering. Is equal to current that is leaving is I1.
IS
so,
is entering. I1 is leaving. Yes,
so minus. It can also be written as VS by
I1.
I1. Okay. So ZI is nothing but V1 by I1. Suppose if it is ZIS, it is nothing but VS by I1 or else VS by IS. Okay. Now let us see. So I want input impedance, which is ZI. What should I do? Only you need to remember this equation. V1 is equal to H11 I1 plus H12 V2. Next one is I2 is H21 I1 plus H22 V2. So experiment with these two equations and find the value of V1 by I1. What should I do from this? Which equation should I use? Equation 1 or 2? See, if I divide this equation.
Yes.
So I'm dividing equation number 1 by I1. So let's see here. V1 by I1 is equal to H11 I1. I'm dividing it with I1 plus H12 V2 by I1. So here I1 and I1 and cancel. V1 by I1 can be written as
ZI.
So ZI is equal to H11 plus H12 V2 by I1. So already we know the voltage V2. So what is V2? Here V2 can be written as IL into RL. RL's minus I2 times RL. Okay, I'm substituting V2 as minus I2 RL. So instead of V2, H11 plus H12. Instead of V2, minus I2 RL by I1. Clear till here? Now, what I know, current gain, it is defined as a ratio of output IL by I1. Or IL can be written as minus I2 by I1. Yes or no? So here, instead of minus I2 by I1, I will replace this part. Instead of minus I2 by I1, I'll replace it with AI. Can I write it? H11 plus H12, this becomes AI RL. This is nothing but input impedance. Clear or any doubt with this? Yes, everyone. Is it clear? But let me call a number.
Yes, sir.
Roll number 315.
Sir.
What is the equivalent for H11? H11 can be written as? Mm. 11. What is the meaning? H11 means? V1 by I1 here. Suppose if I want H11, I need to make this part as 0. Okay, so H11 is nothing but V1 by I1. So it can be written as? What is the name for it? H11 is also called as? Is it input impedance or else output impedance, voltage gain, current gain?
Input impedance.
So it should be replaced as HIE or HOE?
HIE.
IE. Should I write E or not here?
Yes.
Or if I'm doing it for common emitter model, you need to write. Or else only HI is enough. So here ZI can be written as HI. What about H12? H12 means? Just now I told. Forward or reverse?
Reverse.
Reverse. So it can be written as HR followed by AIRL. This is all about input impedance. Next one, voltage gain. Can anyone tell me how to calculate voltage gain? Voltage gain. See, yes, voltage gain means? Which one is output voltage here?
Output voltage by input voltage.
Output voltage is V1 or V2?
V2, sir.
Okay, V2. V2. Input is?
V1.
Now you tell me.
V1.
How to solve? Already you know V2. V2 is nothing but minus I2 RL.
RL.
Next, which equation should I use? We have two equations. V1 is H11 I1 plus H12 V2. Next, I2 is H21 I1 plus H22 V2. Which one should I use from this?
V1 is equals to.
V1, okay. Tell me how should I solve? Whatever you want, you do. But I want V2 by V1. I've given you three equations. Solve those three equations and tell me the answer for voltage gain AV. Try it. Yes. Any idea on how to calculate voltage gain AV? Yes, AV, it is defined as change in output V2 by V1.
Then
however, I know this. V2 is nothing but minus I2 times RL.
Yeah.
So simply I'm substituting. It is nothing but V2 by V1. So here V2 can be written as minus I2 RL by V1. Now what should I do? From current gain AI, it is nothing but minus I2 by I1. So minus I2 can be written as AI times I1. So here AV is nothing but instead of minus I2, I'm writing it as AI I1 RL by V1. So I'm rewriting this equation as AI into RL. I'm bringing this I1 down. So it becomes V1 by I1. So what is the equivalent for V1 by I1? Input voltage by input current. Equivalent is?
ZI.
Correct. This is ZI. So simply replace. So this becomes AI into RL by ZI. So this is nothing but voltage gain. Voltage gain is nothing but AI into RL by ZI. Clear or any doubts with this? This is the derivation for voltage gain. Next parameter, output impedance or else output admittance, anything you can calculate. So what is the difference? How should I calculate input and how should I calculate the output? Both are same or else any modifications that I need to do? Here you tell me. Here it is voltage followed by resistor. This is nothing but Thevenin's equivalent. Okay. Suppose if I want to calculate output, remove this part. Means it is acted as open circuit. That is RL is nothing but infinite. Okay, this is first step. In the next step, suppose if input is voltage, it should be shorted or open. Voltage source should be short-circuited or open-circuited?
Short.
This should be
circuited, sir.
So you short-circuit this path and you remove this part here. It should be open-circuited. Now you try to calculate. I want output admittance. So output admittance means, is it Y or Z?
Y.
Y. Y means output. So it is V out by I out or I out by V out? Y means?
I out by V out, sir.
This is I out by V out. So you try to calculate now. And tell me the answer for this. What is V out and what is I out? So here we are assuming V out is nothing but V2. Okay. V out or V2, depending upon your requirement you take. Solve it and tell me. Output admittance. See, this is an important case. Generally, you may get this for 2 marks also. However, if you are trying to calculate output impedance, always input should be short-circuited. Suppose if it is voltage, shorted. Suppose if it is current source, it should be open-circuited. And RL should be infinite. Means it is acting as open-circuit. See, these are the two conditions which you need to follow while calculating output. So V1 is 0 and RL is infinite. So I here Y naught is nothing but output current by output voltage. So Y naught is nothing but output by output. So here we are assuming that output current I naught is nothing but I2 and V out is nothing but V2. So which equation should I use now? We know two equations. Next is I2 is H21I1 plus H22V2. Which one you want? Which one you want to use from this?
Second
one. Simply you divide this equation. Suppose if this is equation number 2, dividing equation number 2 with respect to V2. Okay, I'll write here as V2. So I2 by V2 is nothing but I2 by V2 is equal to, this is H21I1 by V2 plus H22. Here you can also substitute. Here V2 is nothing but, what is V2? Minus I2 RL. So here I2 by V2 is nothing but H21 I1, whereas V2 is nothing but minus I2 RL plus H22. Minus I2 by I1. We know that current gain is nothing but minus I2 by I1. But here it is I1 by minus I2. So what is the replacement for this? I2 by V2 is H21 into AI or divide by AI? It is reciprocal. I1 by minus I2 is nothing but 1 by AI. So here it becomes AI into RL plus H22. You can get two answers for this. So this is one thing and this is another method. See this. Here what I did, I divided equation 2 with respect to V2 so that I got all this. Till here we are done. Next, I am applying KVL within the input loop. Can I apply KVL in the input loop here? If this voltage is shorted. Yes, anyone? Suppose if I want to write KVL, can I write it? Or is directly you can go with equation number 1 also in the same manner. V1 is H11 I1 plus H12 V2. So dividing this one with respect to V2, why? Because V1 is nothing but 0. Here V1 is nothing but Vs. voltage short is sorted so that V1 will also be equivalent to zero. Simply substitute those conditions here. I'm dividing this one with respect to V2. So that I1 by V2 is nothing but minus HR by HI. HR is nothing but 1, 2 and this is H11. This is equivalent to I1 by V2. Clear? There are two formulas for this. Either in this method you can go or else directly you can use this one also. Why? Because already I know the current gain formula AI. So in this manner also you can replace. Okay, clear or any doubts with this? Output admittance. Yes, how to calculate output admittance? Is it clear? Output by output, output current by output voltage, which is nothing but I2, this is V2. So I'm using equation number 2 and I'm dividing it with respect to V2. Till here, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I've divided I2 by V2. Next. Here, H21. What is H21? Forward. H22, output. I hope you are clear till this point. Okay. So simply I've divided equation number 2, which is nothing but I2 by V2. So that I got equation number 16. Now, from equation number 1, we know this one. V1 is H11 I1 plus H12 V2. Now, divide it by V2 and taking V1 is equal to 0. Why I should take V1 is equal to 0? What are the two conditions to calculate output admittance? Why not? First one is RL is infinite, RL, which is open circuited. Next.
Voltage is there, short circuited.
Short circuited. So, obviously, Vs is nothing but 0. If Vs is 0, obviously, input voltage will also be 0. Okay, so dividing equation number 17 with respect to V2. So here V1 is 0. Okay, so that I got 0. Next, H11 into I1 divided by V2. Next, here V2 and V2 will get cancelled, so that I got H12. Next, what I did here, just have replaced. Instead of H11, I've written as HI. Instead of H12, I've written as HR. Clear till here?
Yes, sir.
Now next, moving this part towards left-hand side. So that H1... HI into I1 by V2 is minus HR. So I1 by V2 is nothing but minus HR by HI. So simply substitute 19 in 16. So this one and this one. Okay, so that it becomes in this part, I've substituted I1 by V2 as minus HR by HI. So that you'll get I2 by V2. Or else you can go with the first formula also. Okay, everything is same. First, simply, I took equation number 2 and I've divided it with respect to V2. And directly, if it is, how much we got, it is I1 by minus I2. So, which is nothing but current gain AI, 1 by AI. Either you can substitute this one or else you can go with this one also. Both are same. So, is it clear? Four parameters. Current gain, input impedance, voltage gain. Next one is output admittance. Clear or any doubts? First four parameters. Next one is overall voltage gain. What is the difference between overall voltage gain and only voltage gain? What is the difference? By seeing this, you tell me what is voltage gain AV and what is overall voltage gain AVS? Are both are same or different? See, suppose if it is voltage gain, it is nothing but output by input. Here output is V2 and input is V1, so that AV can be written as V2 by V1. Suppose if it is AVS, means source should also be considered. So this is output V2, whereas which one I should take? IS, sorry, VS or V1?
VS.
VS, this is a change. Overall means you need to include this source network also. Suppose if it is only voltage gain, no need of considering this source. This is the change between normal voltage gain as well as overall voltage gain. Now you tell me how to solve this. See, only I have considered the input part, which contains source network. This is a source network, which is Thevenin's equivalent. Voltage in series with resistor followed by input resistance RA. So here AVS is nothing but output voltage is V2, input is Vs. So I'm writing this something like this. V2. Here it is Vs. I'm dividing, multiplying, divided with respect to V1. Okay. So that what I know, V2 by V1. What is V2 by V1? AV. Suppose if it is V2 by Vs, it is AVS. You need to remember these two. So instead of V2 by V1, I'm writing it as AV. So that AVS can be written as voltage gain AV times V1 by Vs. Now you apply voltage division rule here. Wait, let me call a rule number. Rule number 316. Tell me voltage division rule to calculate V1. V1. What is total voltage?
Vs by.
First, tell me the formula. What is voltage division rule? Total voltage into.
Total voltage into opposite by.
What opposite? Opposite resistance or voltage?
Opposite resistance.
By total resistance. Now you tell me. Total voltage is Vs. What is the opposite resistance? Ri or Rs?
Ri.
Opposite by total. Ri plus Rs.
Rs.
Now I want V1 by Vs. So from here I can write V1 by Vs is nothing but Ri by Ri plus Rs. So simply I'm substituting this part here. So that overall voltage gain AVS is nothing but voltage gain into Ri by Ri plus Rs. This is nothing but overall voltage gain. Clear? Overall voltage gain. Next parameter is overall current gain. Now you tell me this one. What is the difference between this one and the previous that we have seen? Both are same or different?
Different.
Which part? What is this part?
Source network.
This is nothing but source network. Thevenin's or Norton's?
Norton's.
This is Norton's. Now, what is the difference between normal current gain and overall current gain? You tell me the values. AI and I want AIS. What is AI and what is AIS? Let me open the diagram.
I2 minus I2.
Yes, you tell me for AI. AI is
minus I2 by
IL
A1.
By.
Okay, IL by
I1.
Correct. Both are correct. Okay. Minus I2 by I1 or else IL by I1. Right. Next. IS I want now.
IL by IS.
Correct.
IL by
IS. Or else minus I2 by IS. So if you're clear with this part, easily you can understand. See now. So overall current gain. So AIS is nothing but output current. What is output? This is nothing but minus I2 by IS. So here you need to multiply and divide with respect to I1. So this is I2. Here I'm writing as IS. Divide, multiply and divide with respect to I1. So here minus I2 by I1 means AI. So that AIS is nothing but AI into I1 by IS. Okay. Now, which rule will you apply here in order to calculate I1 at this point? Should I apply voltage division rule or else current division rule?
Current.
Yes. Tell me.
Current.
Suppose if it is I1, I want I1 now. What is total current?
IS.
Okay. Total current into opposite resistance is?
RS.
RS by?
RS plus RA.
RS plus RA. So my requirement is I want I1 by IS. So from here you can write I1 by IS is nothing but RS by RS plus RA. Simply substitute this part so that AI is nothing but AI into RS by RS plus RA. Clear? So remember this current division rule. Suppose here this is the flow of current I1. Opposite will become obviously RS. It's not RI. Okay, why? Because current through the resistor or else current across the resistor?
Current across.
Current across or current through? Current through.
Current.
Always current will flow through the resistor, means like this. Okay, two points are very important. Obviously, this is an 100% question in your Viva also. Okay, after the completion of your lab experiments, the external will ask you these questions only, mostly. So clear with AIS. Next part is overall input resistance. Now you tell me, what is the difference between input resistance RI and overall input resistance RA? Already I think we have written this part. From here you tell me. See, ZI or RA, both are same. This is RI, yes. So what is RA? What is input voltage?
V1 by I1.
Input voltage V1 by I1. Suppose if you want RIS?
VS by I.
VS by?
I.
IS.
Yes.
IS is same as?
I1.
IS is same as I1. Clear? So let us substitute now. Now I'm calculating overall input resistance. So I've took for Thevenin's. Okay, there's nothing but Thevenin's equivalent. So apply KVL. So let me call a rule number. You need to tell me how to write KVL. Rule number 314, Rakesh. Abdul.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, tell me KVL for this.
There it is. Plus ISRS. Minus VS. Starting with minus VS.
So first I've started from here. So plus ISRS. Okay. Next.
Plus IIRI.
II. Where is II? Here only the current
sorry.
IS.
Yes. IS, sir. IS into RI, sir.
Okay. Next.
Minus VS. Minus is equal VS to zero.
So take IS as common. So RS plus RI, which is nothing but VS. So I want RIS. So here RIS is defined as VS by IS. So however VS is there, IS is there. So move this part here. So VS by IS is nothing but RS plus RI. This is all about RIS. Okay, this is overall input resistance. Next one, overall output admittance. So here, what are the two important parameters that I need to follow for calculating output?
VS equal to.
Okay, if there is voltage, it is zero. That is nothing but short circuit. Suppose if it is current?
Open circuit.
Open.
Infinite, right.
Right, infinite. Next. Next condition, RL is? Infinite, which is nothing but it should act as open circuit. Always you need to follow these two points while calculating output. Now you tell me, I want YOS, output admittance. S stands for overall. See here, by definition, Y naught is obtained by setting VS is equal to zero. So I'm going with Thevenin's model. That's why VS is zero and RL is infinite. Next, and by driving the output terminal from a generator V2. So what I did is, suppose the small signal model, it looks something like this at the output part. This is H22. So suppose if there is a resistor, I've removed that part. Okay, so here it is open circuited. So the voltage here is V2. I'm driving it with respect to V2. Next, if the current drawn from V2 is I2, then Y0 is nothing but output voltage by output current. Suppose Y0 is nothing but what is output current? It is I0 and output voltage is V0. Or else from our assumption, it is I2 by V2. These two conditions are very important. VS is zero and RL is infinite. So I want I2 by V2. So I'm going with equation number two. I2 is H21 I1 plus H22 V2. Simply you divide this with respect to V2. Okay, so that I got I2 by V2. And here H21 into I1 by V2. So here V2 and V2 gets cancelled. Next, what I need to do? What is the condition? V1 will also be become 0. Vs is 0 as well as V1 is 0. Okay, from the input part. See here. This is a small signal equivalent model. This is nothing but source network with this Thevenin's equivalent. And the condition is I need to remove this part. This should act as an open circuit and this part should act as short circuit. So this is the equivalent diagram. This is open circuited. This is short circuited. So this is nothing but source part. Middle one is two port equivalent model. And this part is nothing but load. Now apply KCL at this point. Sum of current entering is equal to leaving. So here IS is I1. Okay. Next, suppose if I want to write KVL within this path, how should I write? Rule number 305. KVL within this loop. KVL.
Minus ISRS.
Why minus ISRS?
Positive.
Now you tell me. ISRS. Next. Already we have completed almost 2 units. Still you are not telling me how to write KVL. Plus ISRS. Next. This part.
Minus I1 H11.
You tell me which rule you are following. What is the rule that you are following? In these two cases, which rule you are following? If it is going from positive to negative, you are writing it as minus or plus? So there are multiple ways to write. So that's why I'm asking which rule you are following. Generally, if you are going from positive to negative, suppose if the current that is flowing is I and if this is R, generally if you are going from positive to negative, I will write it as IR. And here, suppose if I'm going from negative to positive, I'll write it as plus IR. Okay, generally you will see this one in textbooks. Okay, but what I told you, take the starting value. Suppose if it is plus, simply write it as plus I into R. You follow this one. Either if you're perfect, you can go with these two cases also, no issue. Okay, but generally the signs mismatch will happen. Now from this, which one you are following?
First one.
Yeah, tell me then. According to your case only, you tell me.
Minus ISRS.
Minus ISRS.
Minus I1 H11.
Okay.
Minus H12 V2. Plus VS.
Why VS? There is no voltage source itself. Zero. Next, apply KCL at this point. IS is entering, I1 is leaving. So IS is equal to I1. So minus I1 RS minus I1 H11 is equal to H12 V2. Taking minus I1 as common. So that RS, next. H11 is equal to H12 V2. So here I want YOS output I2 by V2 I want. So I got I1 by V2 as H12 by RS plus H11. So here I'm writing it as minus. Okay, you can see both the cases are okay. So as you have followed this one, it is okay. Or else if you want, you can follow this one also. Now I got I1 by V2 is minus H12 by RS plus H11 I got. Now my requirement is I2 by V2. So what should I do here to get this one? You substitute in this part. I1 by V2 is nothing but this one. So that I'll get I2 by V2 as H21 into minus H12 by RS plus H11 plus H22. Clear? Only two rules that you need to follow is Vs is zero and RL is infinite. That is open circuited, whereas input is short circuited. So this is all about the overview of bipolar junction transistor analysis. But in exam, he will ask you to write any four. So generally, he will ask current gain, input impedance, voltage gain.
So all this output. We have to write, sir.
You need to derive all these four. So these are nothing but overall analysis part. For which generally he will ask you to derive only for four. In that also, he may ask for common emitter, common base, common collector. Any one you may get from this. So that you need to derive current gain, input impedance, voltage gain, output admittance. Generally, this he will concentrate more on this four parameters itself. Okay, but for the safe side, I will explain to you all the other remaining models also, like overall voltage gain, overall current gain, overall input resistance, and overall output. Okay, better you go through this all eight. But in exam, you have to write only for first four. So this is the task for you. You need to analyze the BJT amplifier using exact H parameter model for CE, CB, and CC. So what is the difference? Can you tell me? What's the difference? However, you got all the answers directly. See here. The answer for current gain I want now. So here the answer is something like this. It looks something like this. So simply instead of F, you put it as E. This is your answer for common emitter. This is minus HFE by 1 plus HOE RL. This is the answer for current gain in case of CE. Suppose if you want it for common base, the answer becomes minus HFB by 1 plus HOB RL. No changes will be there here. Okay, so already you have derived answers for all the models, CE, CB as well as CC. Only you need to add that subscript. Okay, so this is the task for you. So analysis for CE, CB as well as CC. You need to tell me the answers for those models, right? Using H parameter model. And the last type of analysis is approximate analysis, which is also same as H parameter model. But the small change is here. If you observe the small signal model, can anyone tell me the small signal model? Input part will be H11I1, H12V2. This one becomes H21I1.
H22V2.
This is H22V2. H22. Till here we know. This is nothing but exact H parameter model. But there are some disadvantages with this. What are the disadvantages that you observed? Here the calculations are very lengthy. That's the main problem with this. So here it is I2. Here it is I1. So the main thing is, if you want detailed analysis, you need to go with this exact model. Suppose if you want for approximate analysis, two changes that will happen here. Here, this part becomes open circuited. H22 will act as open circuited, whereas H12V2 will act as short circuited. That's the only change. Okay, so that the equivalent model looks something like this. H11, this is shorted. Okay, this is the approximate model. H11I1, this is H21I1. Rest everything is same. Why I need to short circuit this part and why I need to open circuit this one? Any idea on this? So generally, what
because
is the speed of amplifier?
H12 is increasing.
Yeah, tell me H12 is? So if I want H12 can be written as? V1 by V2. But what is our requirement? Why you are studying about these amplifiers? What is the main motto? What is the need of amplifier? Yes, Samyukta, what is the need of amplifier?
Sir, it amplifies the weak signal.
It amplifies the weak signal. So? Can you call it as gain? So input will be small or more compared to output?
Small.
Yes, input is small and output is generally large. So suppose if this is output V2, this is V1. So my requirement is V2 by V1 or else V1 by V2. Suppose if I'm assuming V1 as 0 and V2 as infinite. Now substitute in this. V2 by V1 is? V2 by V1. Here V1 is nothing but 0. 1 by 0 is? Infinite. Here we substitute V2 as infinite. So that it becomes 0. What is the difference between these two? This is V1 by V2 and this is V1 by V2. What is the difference? We are concentrating on 1 or 2. We want more gain or less gain? Yes, why we studied all these parameters? For the sake of calculation of output by input ratio, not input by output ratio. So in H12, you can see here, V1 is input, whereas V2 is output. This is not at all needed. Suppose you substitute V2 as infinite. So 1 by infinite is? Zero. I'm getting output as zero. So what is the use of this parameter? Clear? So that's why I'm removing this parameter. Always, my intention is I want output by input ratio, not input by output. So that's why I'm short circuiting this part. And what about this one? H22. Actually, in order to say, there are some of the standard values for this. So spreadsheet will be there. See, these are some of the standard values. For H11 is nothing but HI. The standard value is 1100 ohm. Okay. And for H12, which is nothing but HRE reverse. So the equivalent, the answer for this is 2.5 into 10 power minus 4. So for an every transistor, specification sheet will be given. Specification sheet. Generally, this is for common emitter. Okay. These are the values for H1. H1 is 1100 ohm. Suppose if it is H12, it is 2.5 into 10 power minus 4. So how can I write this one? This is 0.0002, which is very small. So neglect. Next, if it is H21, H21 is nothing but 50. H21 is also called as HFE, which can also be called as beta. You need to remember this. Beta or else HFE, both are same. Okay. Next, H22. H22 is nothing but 1 by 40 kilo ohm. Here, what is H22? Output admittance or else output impedance? H22.
Output admittance.
Correct. It is output admittance. Suppose in the output part, here suppose instead of H22, if I write 1 by H22, then the equivalent answer will be 40 kilo ohm. Suppose if I write it as H22, it becomes 1 by 40 kilo ohm. Okay, which is very small, so this can also be neglected. Suppose if you get some problem in exam, which model will you use? Will you go with approximate or else exact H parameter model? How to know which one should I use? See, you need to check this. This is H11I1 voltage, current, this one. Here generally I'll connect load resistor RL. This is H22, H11. You need to take the product of these two. H22 multiplied with RL. Suppose if you get the answer less than 0.1, go with approximate analysis. Excuse me. Suppose if the answer is greater than 0.1, go with exact analysis. That is nothing but H parameter, exact model. Okay, this is a way to identify. Simply, you do the product of these two, H22 into RL, and depending upon the answer, you go. Suppose if it is approximate analysis, this part should be shorted and this part should be open. Okay, suppose if it is exact model, no changes in this. Direct analysis, which you have seen, see all these cases, same manner. This is nothing but exact hybrid parameter model. See, approximate model for CE. So what is the change that you observed here? Already we have seen the equivalent hybrid parameter model for CE. Here, what is the change? Or else let me go to the H parameter model diagram. See, this is CE H parameter model. Now suppose if I want to convert this into approximate, what are the changes? This part should be shorted.
Shorted. Open.
This should be open circuited. That's it. Again, everything is same. No changes. Observe this. That's nothing but approximate model. Generally, you may or may not. You may get or may not get this one. So here, I shorted here. This is nothing but open circuited. This is approximate model for CE. Rest everything is same. This is source network. This is load network. Next, for approximate model CB, again same. This is shorted. Here it is open circuited. And this is a task for you. Approximate model for CC. You need to draw this and tell me. Okay. So with this, we are done with unit 2. So first, read in detail about this H parameter model so that easily you can write approximate. So once if you are perfect with this hybrid parameter exact model, then approximate model is generally easy. Rule number 18, Yashwant. Rule number 19, Sai Charan. Can you explain when I should use exact hybrid parameter model and approximate model? How will you identify? Next rule number. Rule number 304.
Yes, sir.
Yes, Ramakrishna, tell me. When should I use approximate model and when should I use exact H parameter model?
Yes, simply,
how will you identify?
Product of H22 into RL.
Suppose if it is less than 0.1, what will happen? If it is greater than 0.1, what will happen?
Greater than 0.1 means H parameter.
Okay, H parameter model, which is nothing but exact. Next. Less than 0.1 means?
Approximate.
So you are clear. So any doubts in today's session? So first you try to go in detail, starting from here, from small signal model. Definitely one long question you may get here. At the same time, you need to draw these diagrams for short, 2 marks also. Don't lose marks in this. So directly you can write here, H parameter model for CE, CB, as well as CC. Sometimes he may try to confuse you by asking either PNP and NPN. So be perfect with both the cases. Generally, NPN will be there. But sometimes you may get PNP also. Okay, clear? No more doubts? I'm not getting any response. So I would like to give you some task for next lab session. So I want you to explain. You need to do an PPT on this basic electronic circuits. Like you need to take capacitors, and you need to explain in detail about that by making a PPT on resistors, capacitors, and inductors. So this is the task. Next one is function generator, working about function generator. So lateral entry students, do you know about this? I hope you have worked on this function generator, CRO.
So what is this function generator, sir? We have same CRO, sir.
Cathode ray oscilloscope, you know. Function generator means generally I'm applying the source like this, right? VS followed by RS. This is AC, means generally sinusoidal in nature. So this frequency, so generally F is equal to 1 by T. See, the frequency, suppose if it is 50 Hertz, you can set that in this function generator. By rotating the knob, you can set the frequency depending upon your application. If it is 50 Hertz, 50. 100 Hertz. Suppose if you don't know, no issue. But I want everyone to make a PPT. Who wants to do on capacitors? Randomly, if you are interested, you can take. So capacitors, in detail you need
everyone
to take.
Should do, sir.
No, no. Each and everyone individually you take.
No, in sir. Future, each and everyone should do.
Not individual, or else let me assign it to the roll numbers. Who wants to take this topic? Depending upon your interest, you tell me. I'm not forcing anyone. Capacitors, who wants?
14, sir.
Roll number 14, capacitor, right. Next, inductors. Samyukta, I want you to do on function generator if you are interested. And Tanvi on CRO.
Sir, I want rest.
Resistor,
roll
number
two, resistor.
Roll number two, resistor. Inductor. Inductor. Take only if you are interested. I'm not forcing you. Inductors.
I will take, sir, inductor.
Number?
309.
Next, on voltmeters and ammeters. I'm noting these numbers.
311, sir.
311 wants to take on voltmeter and okay.
Sir,
by so by the next, sir, lab you be next, who is this?
When we should do
next lab? By next Tuesday. Okay, randomly I'll assign time for you so that you need to make a PPT on this. Be ready with PPT as well as Word document. Detailed capacitor, working of capacitor, followed by all the formulas of capacitors. And types of capacitors. Types of capacitors. You need to cover everything. Yes.
CRO full form.
CRO means cathode ray oscillator or also oscilloscope. Cathode ray oscilloscope. So can you do it, this Tanvi, CRO?
Yes, sir.
Next, what about you, Samyukta? Do you want to do on function generator or else capacitor?
We'll go with function generator, sir.
Function generator. Then who wants this topic, capacitor? Make a neat PPT. It should be crystal clear with all the topics covered. Next, who wants this, capacitor? So inductors, rule number 309, resistor, rule number 2, function generator, CRO is 5, voltmeter and ammeter is 311. What about you, Shivani, 316? Do you want to take?
Yes, sir.
I'm not forcing. If you're interested, tell me. Why? Because a few students don't have a system, I think. Again, it will be a headache for you. That's why I'm asking. Do you want to do it? 316? But one thing is, don't download the PPTs directly from the net, okay? At least make by your own. Yes, guys, tell me so that I'll close.
Sir, next Tuesday.
Next Tuesday, yes. Who wants this topic? Capacitors. Or else rule number 2 only will take.
I will take, sir.
Who is this?
319.
319?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So do you know what to do? PPT as well as Word document. Be ready with it so that I'll assign time for you.
Sir, Word document is not there with me, sir.
No, you can type it.
Okay, sir.
And make a PPT, don't download. Write in your own words, okay, so that, sir, you can understand in the future also. Done.
So should we present it in the next class?
Yes, you have to present.
Explain also?
Everything. You need to explain the detailed working of all the models. Like if there are any types in that, you need to explain, followed by you need to submit the Word document as well as PPT.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Right. Thank you.